Welcome back. This time we're talking about Legion, Season 1, Episode 6, Chapter 6. I have to say, even taking into account the standard that this show has set over the first 5 episodes, Chapter 6 is an amazing hour of television, exemplifying everything I like about Legion, from the acting performances to the writing to everything about the production, from the costume set design all the way to the music and how the sound is mixed. All of it combining to once again create a very trippy atmosphere, which is very apt since once again the vast majority, or pretty much the entire episode, it takes place inside David's head, or at least some kind of astral plane created by David. Now I say created by David because I do believe whatever situation we're in was created by David. It does seem that Lenny is the one that's actually in control. But I'll get into that more in a little bit. For now, let me just say that this is an episode that gave the writers a chance to go full-on crazy, while also giving the audience some interesting character development points for some of our other characters aside from David, while saving the best for last by giving us some very interesting clues as to exactly what Lenny slash the Devil with the Yellow Eyes is and how his relationship with David began. But before I dive into the episode itself, let me say I'm really happy to see that FX has officially picked up Legion for a second season. This has easily become my favorite new show on television. I love watching it. I love talking about it. That's why I keep doing these videos, and I do hope that you enjoy them. You know, they're labeled reviews, but they're more just a conversation with me talking about my thoughts of what happened and where it may lead. So if you're interested in being the other half of this conversation, do feel free to comment below with any insights of your own, any questions you might have, or critiques, positive or negative, on anything that I say about the episode. And with that said, let's dive into this. Like I did with my review of Chapter 5, I'm more or less going to go in chronological order, because it's the easiest way to keep everything I want to talk about straight, especially since this is such an unusual episode from a narrative standpoint. To begin, I actually want to start with the end of the previous episode and the cliffhanger that brought us to where we are in this episode, and that is the confrontation in David's childhood home when Afro Man, as I like to call him, in the disguise of the telekinetic, fires on David. Sid puts herself in the way and tells him to go to the White Room. He goes to the White Room with her, and they are both attacked by the Devil with the Yellow Eyes. She screams for help, and then he does something, and we are now in this psych ward setting where it appears that everyone no longer remembers where they came from, what their lives were really like, and now they all believe that they're actually patients in this psych ward, except for Lenny, who is the doctor, and Amy, who is playing the role of a nurse, and I'll get into more of her character a little bit later. Now, 2 points on this whole cliffhanger. First, and this is something I did mention in my video, was that it appeared that the danger of the bullets would remain as sort of a ticking clock while we were in whatever fantasy world this is. And from what we see in this week's episode, that seems to be the case. And the second, and this is something I really didn't get into in much detail, was this setting, whose creation is it? It appeared to me that it was David's creation. This episode basically begins with a series of scenes as Lenny, posing as the doctor, is interviewing all of the various characters. And again, at this point, it wasn't quite clear if Lenny was being forced to play a role just like everyone else, or if she had some kind of autonomous control over her actions. As we see later in this episode, she does. But what this series of scenes does do is give us some insight into some of these other characters and where their headspace is. The first one we see is Dr. Bird. In all of these, they're playing on the idea that they don't have powers, they have not lived these extraordinary lives, they're just damaged people who, for one reason or another, are patients in this psychiatric hospital. In the case of Dr. Bird, it's her pining for her husband and literally keeping him frozen, something she continues to claim in this version of herself, but something that Lenny is claiming is just a metaphor for not letting go of her dead husband. Next, we see Tonami, and this is probably the most interesting insight into any of the characters, because we know who Tonami is, we have a decent grasp of what his powers are, but we really haven't gotten much of any backstory on him. And it's here that we learn that apparently his mother died when he was young in front of him, and he continues to live that memory. We've seen him go into other people's memories, but honestly, I didn't put much thought into how his power interacts with his own memories. But from what we see in this episode, it appears that he has some kind of eidetic memory in which he can actually relive any moment of his past, and the moment that he keeps getting drawn back to is this moment in which his mother dies. He actually refers to himself as a time traveler, which is a very interesting way to look at that kind of memory manipulation and control. If you could go back to any moment in your life and very vividly, very accurately relive it, you're essentially a time traveler. You can't make any changes, as he bemoans, but you can go back in time and relive the past. Although it's interesting to note that two episodes ago, when they visited the psychiatrist's office and Sid made comment about how things were slightly different, like the pattern on the drapes, Tonami mentioned that memories are not always reliable, but perhaps his memories are as a byproduct of his powers. If nothing else, this is the deepest insight that we've been given into his character up until this point. We also get to see the Carries talking with Lenny, and for the most part, we didn't really learn anything new. We learned more about his powers, or their powers, in the previous episode, but we just get to see, again, them playing off their abilities being seen as sicknesses, which calls back to how David was being treated in the first episode. There's actually a lot of callbacks, both direct and more metaphorical, in this episode. Then we get to see Afro Man. I believe later in this episode, Lenny refers to him as Walter. She refers to Walter, and it was implied that she was talking about him. And we get a little bit of insight into some of his childhood issues over puberty and anger, and I really just don't feel like going into any kind of detail on that. So that's pretty much all we got in this episode, other than that he is a very angry person and has a lot of issues. We then get to see Sid's session, and it's here where we start seeing that Sid, alone out of everyone else, has a sense that something is off, that this world is not real, and that something is clouding their minds to that fact. This could be for several reasons. One, her connection to David, her time in other astral planes while they were in the white room together, or it could be because she once inhabited his bodies and had, if not control, a connection to his powers during that time. We also get to see Amy, and I had questioned at the end of the previous episode whether she was going to be in this scenario, because we did not see her in that final scene before the cliffhanger, and here she is, this nurse, and she's a very unhappy, angry person throughout this episode. She's mean to Sid, she's extremely mean to David throughout this episode, stealing his pie, calling him all kinds of names, and then talking about how he makes her want to throw up, and then actually gagging. That was an incredibly disturbing scene, especially considering the idea that she is his sister. And her whole persona in this episode, I'm a bit confused about. This does not seem to be the Amy that has been concerned about her brother pretty much every time that we've seen her in this show. Yes, she's been scared of him at times, but we've never seen anything to suggest that she's not a loving sister. Again, there could be several explanations for this. David doesn't see Amy as his sister. He sees her as this nurse. She's playing this character a lot like everyone else is, only these other people, their personalities seem to be intact. So, option one, this is actually Amy, and this is her true feelings being released by her being in this astral plane. Option two being that this is Amy, but her actual personality is being overridden by this character that she's being forced to play. And option three, that this is not Amy at all, and only a projection of her look onto this fictional character in this astral plane. I honestly don't know what is the most likely option at this point. We know Amy was in the room when everyone was taken away, but she, again, seems to be the only one playing a out-of-character character. So, until we know more, I don't know. If you have a good idea, definitely comment below and let me know your thoughts on Amy, because she's one of the more confusing aspects of a very, well, confusing episode. We do get a quick sequence of David and Tonami essentially recreating the scene from the first episode involving David and Lenny watching the other patient drool and speculating on what its cause is, and then seeing Sid. Only in this episode, the patient appears to be the telekinetic, meaning that there's a chance that he's actually alive and was not killed by Afro Man. And two, that Sid and David are already in a relationship at this point. And this is also when Sid first sees the door that apparently leads out of this version of the astral plane. Then we get the final session, which is Lenny interviewing David. And this is where we get to see a very content David. He's not the confident David that had been taken over by Lenny. This is a David that now exists in a place that he has no worries. The things that he would have to worry about dealing with other people, situations out of his control, are being controlled by the fact that he is a patient in this psychiatric hospital. And this is why I believe that the overall construction of this version of the astral plane is David's. He went to a place that he felt safe, where he didn't have to worry about people trying to kill him. He didn't have to worry about monsters. He didn't have to worry about expectations. Here, he just goes through his days, he takes his medications, he talks to his doctors, and he gets to hang out with his friends and gets to hang out with his girlfriend. So he seems very content, and we see that throughout this episode with various interactions with Sid, that he's happy here. This is where he wants to be. This is where his subconscious wants to be and doesn't want to be reminded that it's not real. And as I alluded to earlier, throughout all of the scenes that we've seen to this point in the episode, it's not clear whether Lenny has any more control over her situation than anyone else. She could be under David's control as well and being forced to play this role of the doctor because someone had to play it. Well, that possibility goes out the window when we see Lenny in a very, very trippy, and even trippy for this show, sequence, dancing and gyrating and just going crazy. It's like a Bond sequence. That's actually what I wrote down in my notes, Bond sequence, because it's just, it's crazy. It's very cool, very, very trippy, and then it sort of evolves into her jumping through David's various memories that we've seen before, and ultimately coming back into the psychiatric hospital through the unusual door that Sid had seen earlier. And that's when we know that she definitely has more control, or at least conscious control, over what's going on than anyone else, including David. And that's an incredibly scary prospect for our characters, to be in a astral plane situation when Lenny is the only one that has conscious control over her actions. We get to see a quick dream sequence with Sid, and this is the first instance where we get to see the bullets and some proof that they are indeed sort of hanging over our characters, a sort of a ticking clock, or at least a reminder that when they get out of this situation, there's danger remaining in the real world and not just Lenny at all in David's head. Sid eventually wakes up, and we once again get a recreation of a scene from the first episode, only this time it's David going to Sid's room, putting the pillow down and them having a conversation. And this, again, reiterates the idea that David does not want to leave here, even if Sid eventually does leave. Skipping ahead a little bit, we get to see the two Carries having a conversation. And it's during this conversation that male Carrie's dreams of an ice cube come into play. And we get to see that later on in the episode where he actually does go to sleep and dreams of the ice cube and somehow is drawn into the astral plane as what we saw in several episodes ago. And he ultimately comes into contact with Oliver in his underwater suit. We then jump back to David and Sid, and it's after she leaves David's room that she sees sort of the blister on the wall, and when she touches it, it starts bleeding, and when she does touch it, she starts getting some of her actual memories back, that this is actually a wound in this astral creation. But before she can react to it, she's confronted by Lenny, who puts her to sleep, and we get a very cool sequence with the music and the crickets, and she kind of just gets put to sleep, essentially. But in an episode that has some really great camera work and everything else, this was one of the best. It was just, again, the production values on this show are amazing. And what they're able to do with them is even more amazing. We then get the creepiest scene of this episode, and that is when the other Carrie goes into male Carrie's room to see that he's gone, because he's apparently gone off with Oliver, although she doesn't know that. And she's confronted by Afro Man, and he comes off as the whole serial killer vibe. And exactly what he wanted and what he is going to do is left ambiguous, but whatever it is, I don't want to know, and I hope it doesn't happen. And then after another uncomfortable scene with David and Amy, we get to see Dr. Bird, and now she's the second person to be approached by Oliver, and he leads her literally through a wall and down a corridor that takes her back to where they were in the real world when all of this started, with the bullets still being frozen in air and traveling, albeit extremely slowly, towards Sid. Now, whether this is actually the real world or an astral recreation, I don't really know. But it's obvious that Oliver is trying to warn her of the danger that is awaiting them when they return to the real world. And we see Dr. Bird trying to stop the bullets, but it burns her. She tries to move Sid and David and cannot. Whether it's because of their weight or because time is literally frozen here is unclear. But we do get that really creepy scene where the eyes open up in the background. It's like, what the heck was that? I don't know. I'm assuming that was Lenny getting an idea that someone is manipulating things, and that might be why she seems to push up her agenda. Whether or not this does lead to our next scene, that scene is David once again encountering Lenny as he's trying to find Sid because he can't find her anywhere. And Sid starts telling him this story about the ant fungus. I'm not going to try to pronounce the scientific name because I would completely butcher it, but it's the ant fungus. If you've ever read the book, The Girl with All the Gifts, you know what that fungus is. It's a fungus that infects ants down in the rainforest and basically turns them into controllable zombies where they go, their bodies are compelled to climb a tree where then the fungus grows out of its head and send spores out to infect other ants. It's incredibly creepy and actually true, and that's the creepiest part about that. But she goes in this whole monologue about this fungus and where it's going. It's nothing good for David. And she starts railing against him, talking about how love has ruined him, his love for Sid, his companionship and friendships he's building with the people around him. This leads Lenny to ask, you know, what's the point of life? With her eventually saying, all of you running around looking for happiness and fulfillment. And she says you as if humanity is separate from her. And that was the first key moment in this scene. We learned a lot of interesting things in this scene, more so than pretty much everything else in the episode. Everything else was cool. We got some good character moments, got some trippy things and situational things. But as far as like deep, long-term questions potentially being answered, everything was in this scene, in this very few moments, these few minutes, at the end of this very cool episode. But again, this is the first one where she's referring to humanity from the outside. Does that mean she's alien? You know, the theory that Carrie had given was that she is this older, possibly ancient consciousness that was once a mutant but left her human body behind. You know, we've seen this among the tropes of immortals and powerful beings like whatever Lenny is, that they don't see themselves as human or even mutant. They're beyond that. They're godlike. And so her saying you definitely puts her on that plane of ancient slash immortal or potentially alien, but definitely somebody who does not see themselves as normal human slash mutant. And then she talks about how the only reason God matters is because he has power. And this is where she mentions the Walter. Walter understands that. I'm assuming Walter is referring to Afro Man because it does cut to him chasing Carrie once again. And then she starts talking about his father. She knew him, talking about how he had been holier than thou, but then abandoned his son. But then says that he abandoned David to ensure that she couldn't find him, saying that they thought they could hide you from me. But then gloating, saying, I did find you in your sweet body, referring to herself as your very own walking, talking fungus. She then turns into the devil with the yellow eyes, and she apparently saw something in him and felt that they could actually combine their powers to be something even more. And from what we saw at the Division 3 building, their combination is definitely very powerful. But then she bemoans that he basically is wanting to throw all of this away for love and friendship, talking about how she was willing to let him have those things as long as it didn't get into her way. But it has, and now it's too much work, as she refers to it, and that she doesn't need his mind, she only needs his body. That might mean that she doesn't have the same level of powers that she would when they were combined, but she's willing to make that sacrifice because it's just become too annoying to deal with David and his love and friendships. Which leaves David, at the end of this episode, in an incredibly precarious situation, obviously. The last thing we do get to see, however, is Sid sleeping, being woken up by who we first believe is Oliver in his suit, but it turns out it's actually Carrie. He's come to rescue her. So there we go. That's where this episode left us off, with Sid about to be rescued, David about to be eaten, for the lack of a better word, female Carrie being chased by Afro Man, and everyone else sort of just stuck in this astral creation. So outside of those immediate situations, the big thing that we got out of this is more insight into Lenny and what she may or may not be, as well as the idea that she has had a connection with David. She says going all the way back to the womb. That's an interesting way to put it, since we believed, at least up to this point, that David came across him in his early childhood, not while he was in the womb. But either way, that Lenny knew David's biological father, and that man wanted David hidden from this Lenny creature. So at this point, I'm pretty sure that this video is going to be pretty long. There was a lot to talk about in this episode. I had a lot of fun. I hope you had fun listening to me talk about it. As I said earlier, definitely comment below with anything that you want to talk about. I would love this to be a, you know, back and forth conversation about this show. It's a show, as I've said multiple times, I really enjoy talking about it. I would really enjoy listening to other people talk about it. So definitely comment below if you have any questions, comments, critiques, anything like that. I can't wait to the next episode, and if you sat through this entire video, I'm gonna guess that you can't wait either. As always, you can subscribe to my channel, check out some of my other TV and movie reviews, and until next time, don't let anyone say you can't have pie.